Rikers Island. Next.
What's up, guys? RichGamer997 here. Today we're back on MLB The Show 21. If you guys enjoyed this video, it'd be really appreciated if you drop a like, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you never miss another upload. Let's play The Show 21. I would like to wish a happy new year to everyone out there. Hopefully your new year is wonderful and special. I'd like to thank everybody that hit the subscribe button recently. I really appreciate it. Helping the channel grow.
He's kept his average up in recent games. Competition has been fierce, but so far he's managed to fend off all comers in pursuit of a batting title.
Oh, wow. That's not even a good hit.
You don't want somebody to go in a massive slump and fall off the mat. This is going to be a race to the end. Two guys fighting it out. And who's going to have the best finish to the season?
Zatella. I always get beat up. He gets roughed up in the beginning.
Lifted in the air to straightaway center. O'Neill gets under it and makes the catch to end the inning. Fine start in this one after launching a homer his first time up. Hit in the air out to center field. O'Neill gets there for the catch, and that ends the inning. It's a run on two hits here for Baltimore. We play two full. It's the Orioles 3 and the Phillies 1. Next, it'll be Richard O'Neill. He flew out in his last AB.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And he gets there.
Oh, that's bullshit.
And that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Philadelphia. Score holds, it's 3-1. Anthony Santander, the next to bat.
The right fielder.
2-2. High fly ball out to straightaway center. O'Neill is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. So now box.
Yeah, Matty, so difficult to hit from both sides of the plate, but his eyes light up when he's hitting left-handed against the righties out on the mound. He's been torching them all year long.
The windup and the 0-1. Now to the plate here is Richard O'Neill. An uncharacteristic performance from the league's batting average leader, who's been held hitless so far today.
You know, you amass so many.
Oh, damn it.
Usually an O for this late in the game won't kill you. But I'll tell you what, fighting for a batting crown, he can't afford to take an over right here. One knock does not move.
Next to stand in is DJ Stewart. No hits to this point. High fly ball out to straightaway center. O'Neill is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
That was not a good game at all.
Shutting them down for another save. That's an even 100 for his career. So congrats are in order. I'm sure he's going to tuck that ball away and put it in his trophy room.
4-2, the final score tonight. The Baltimore Orioles jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Jake Woodford earns win number 7 on the season. Travis Lakins earns the save out of the bullpen, his 41st of the year. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 51 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
Sunday afternoon baseball from Baltimore. Today it's the third and final game in this three-game interleague series between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Baltimore.
1-54. Richard O'Neill. Definitely making the postseason. I ain't got to worry about that.
Senior Circuit's leading hitter makes his case for a batting title. Next.
Even though we didn't do good in that second game.
Center fielder, and this one is gone, a home run.
When you're facing an elite starter, you know runs are going to be out.
Into the box, Richard O'Neill bounced out last time up.
Yeah, Matty, expect this pitcher to try and get the same result as his last at bat right here. The double play is in order. Anything on the ground, the way this defense is, they can certainly roll too.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel
on,
for his off-speed
stuff. Hard.
And
juice.
That finds the outfield grass for a base hit. And they've really got something going here. Runners at second and third to start the inning. So he picks up another hit. First of the game, but as we've mentioned, it's just one of many so far this season for him.
Yeah, Matty, I know he's fighting for a batting title right now, but the consistency this guy has shown from start to finish this season has been awesome for this team. Talking to the manager before the game, he's the one guy when he walks in the clubhouse door, you know exactly what you're getting from him.
The 3-1. And this one misses for ball four, and now that'll load him up here with nobody out. Stepping in once again is Kyle Lewis. His career numbers in this matchup. He brings a scary .368 batting average. He also has one home run. 0-1, here's the pitch. Grounded softly to the right. He's got it. To second for one. Return throw not in time, and that turned into a closer play than I thought it would at first sight. And not in time as he just crosses the plate in time.
Took a pretty long time for the shortstop to receive the ball that time. So that gave the runner plenty of time to bear down on him and take him out. Hopefully
you're out.
Short and they get two. He's got
five,
a hurry.
Davis
out number two.
I mean, you don't have to start panicking.
Oh, this
son of a bitch.
Out to center, racing back to center fielder. This ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one.
429 feet. pull Zach Eflin out the game. Well, they did pull him out the game.
Now back, Richard O'Neill rounded out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Lifted the other way out to left center. Left fielder is on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
Ball four,
next up, DJ Stewart. He can make these fans go nuts and secure the win if he can place a ball deep enough into the gap. High in the air out to center field. O'Neill is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first.
Driving the run. See what we can do here. Go down.
Here's the first pitch. Hangs on him a bit that time as it's belted out toward deep center.
That's out of here, bitch.
And they take the lead. It's gone.
That's gone. You leave that hanging.
Richard O'Neill has just clubbed a milestone home run of sorts. It's the 100th of his career.
Well, obviously, it's not easy hitting home runs, Matt, especially at this level. 100 home runs is nothing to scoff at, so I'm sure he'll be proud of this accomplishment when he gets to really think about it after a game, and you know he'll want that ball to hold on to.
Best 102nd team win. Mike Foltynewicz earns his third win of the year in relief. Edwin Diaz hammers down the save, his 43rd of the campaign. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to the show.
Unlockable, so I wonder what I got in that one. If it ain't two-handed swings, it's useless. It should be. I wonder if it's the end of the series or there was the next game. Or was one more series? I don't know. I don't remember. Velocity. Welcome, Velocity. A few more games.
Just blocks from the Capitol building, we welcome you to Nationals Park. Tonight, it's an NL Eastern Division showdown between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Washington Nationals.
And now, your 2024
number nine will try to write his name in history books and break the single season home run record. Next, Derek Rodriguez, a right-hander from the state of Texas, is the man on the mound here. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Their ball club is going to have to keep a close eye on this one. This guy's nearing 200 innings on the season, and that's a lot of innings. A guy that takes the ball every 5 days. I'm sure they're going to watch to see if there are any signs of him tiring early in this one.
Stepping up is Richard O'Neill. He's coming off a month in which he earned National League Player of the Month recognition. He's set. Here it comes. Ground ball sent back up the middle. And that finds its way through for a base hit.
Put the brakes on, you biatch.
And he'll settle for a single here as they whip it back in quickly.
There's a hard hit ground ball. Pitcher not able to get a glove on it. Hard single up the middle.
Yeah, watch your lips right there, Dad. Sent it back right where it came from.
Digging in next, Eddie. Rosario, great chance to drive in a run here in the early going. Comes set, 1-0-1. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. Packard retreats to the track, and he'll put this one away. So a sigh of relief as the side is retired. Phillies leave a couple, and now the Nationals get their first opportunity. No score. So now here is Richard O'Neill looking to put them ahead early with this at bat. He's set and the pitch. Hit back toward the mound. And that's through into center field. Base hit. Now a long throw home, but not in time as he's across with the run. Oh, and his remarkable season continues as he's now tied the all-time record for RBIs in a single season.
Think about it, D-Row. Do you know how hard it is to consistently come through when runners are in scoring position or on base? This guy's amazing.
Yeah, people have the ability, Dan, to have ice water in their veins when there's runners in scoring position. Not everybody has the ability to do what this guy's done in his career. What a special moment.
The 0-1 pitch. Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground.
All right, hold on. Hold on right here.
The tag, and he's out at the plate. He'll try to get back now, but it's not going to work. The throw hangs.
That hit him. First base. He's out.
Carter Kieboom digs in now.
Hey, Matty, they need to get some offense going in this one. Getting a run back in this inning, give them a little bit of confidence that they can keep up in this game.
O'Neill is there, and he has it for the first down. So two are gone now in the national sport, and that'll bring in the Illinois State product, Paul DeJong. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. O'Neill will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Three up, three down for Washington.
Three. Four. Take your base. Three.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for Washington, number 58.
Top half of the sixth about to get started. And coming forward is the switch hitting outfielder, Richard O'Neill. First pitch of the AB now. Oh, my. This ball is crushed. Where will this one end up? And gone up into the second deck. Solo shot to right center, and that is home run number 63 on the year, and the Phillies open up a 3-0 lead.
Well, the skipper called on him for a reason, and I can guarantee you one thing, that was not what he had in mind. First pitch, and it was out of here. That's a rough way to start your day at the office as a reliever.
He's out. Three. Out.
Last half of the seventh here, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Paul DeJong.
Not shortstop. Paul.
Hit high and deep to right center. And this is taken in just shy of the warning track for out number one. So a good pitch there. Richard O'Neill will stand in yet again as we flash it back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. Giving chase is Robles. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning.
He's out.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's hitting for Washington. Number 26.
Hey, one down, one down.
high fly ball out to straightaway center. O'Neill is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two. Tonight's game comes to an end, 5-1 the final score. The Phils with their 103rd win to set the pace in the division. Zach Wheeler picks up his team best 14th win in this one as he turns in 8 strong innings of work. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
2 hours and 49 minutes. National Park, the Nationals thank you for your attendance and remind you to
I know, should I continue playing? Or should I save it for the other series? I'll play one more game.
Time now for Baseball on the Show. We're live at Nationals Park here in Washington, D.C. We've got an NL East contest tonight between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Washington Nationals. Number 9. So next to bat will be Richard O'Neill. Watch is fully in effect these days as he's potentially closing in on a historic triple crown. He leads all three categories.
It's not even nasty. It's a 92, but it's fast.
They came out on the losing end last time out and are in a bit of a skid. In fact, they've lost 7 of their last 10.
Yeah, Matty, I hope these guys were listening today during the hitters meeting.
Tag up, you fool. Damn, this nigga didn't move. Look how far that fucking ball went and this nigga didn't tag up. I hope they fix that shit in the show 2022. Can't be having these lazy ass base fucking runners on the game, yo. That shit needs to change.
Drives it out to deep right center field. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. Packard rounds third and is digging for the plate. And he's safe at the plate as they take the lead.
Every manager and every pitcher in the league loves
bottom of the third now. And in steps Carter Kiboom to give it a try.
I'm interested to see how focused their ABs will be playing with this lead. I think this needs to be a little bit of a smell blood inning. Keep the fire rolling. I know it's early, but keep the pressure going. Swinging the bat's nice.
Leading off the inning, it'll be Richard O'Neill. They'll look to spark the offense and even things up. Hit in the air to center field.
Too late on that curveball. Wow, I thought I was fucking early on that curveball. So, wow.
Now at the plate is Richard O'Neill. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. Here's the first pitch. Hit hard up the middle. Oh, a diving stop.
Wow. That's a hell of a play right there. Holy shit.
Location with that fastball up and in on the hands. Hard to do much with that because a hitter really can't extend his arms very easily.
Line drive to center field and a dive, but it rattles in and out of the glove.
Well, you're
usually in this situation looking for a bloop and a blast. He didn't want to bloop it, and he hit a missile, bringing the tying run to the plate. Let's see if they can capitalize.
Next batter is Jamer Candelario. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far.
Hey, this is a real pesky hitter right here. As a pitcher, you really like to keep this guy off the bases. This is a guy that kind of sets the tables for big innings.
It's going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Runner at second now. Nobody out. And into bat next, it'll be Jamer Candelario. O'Neill leads off second with nobody out.
Strike out and a key guy. Don't say that word. Guys, 0 for 3. Damn. Wow. Two back-to-back strikeouts just like that. This is crazy. This game sucks. And he struck out too. Struck out all three of them to end the fucking game. To go in from having no outs to striking out all three fucking guys to end the game, yo. That's crazy. Well, guys, that's going to do it for me tonight. If you guys enjoyed this video, it'd be really appreciated if you drop a like, leave a comment, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so you never miss another upload. Remember, stay safe, wash your hands, wear your mask if you choose to. But most important of all, be kind to each other and tell someone you love them. And have a wonderful new year. Hopefully, you achieve everything that you set forward in this year. And thank you guys for supporting the channel. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a wonderful night. Peace.